ज्ञानं जनसलाशय चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमो। महावदन्नाय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्यनम् गौरद्विषे गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकाय प्रदाये कृष्णाय कृष्ण भक्ताय तदभक्ताय नमो। यं प्रव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेत कृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरह कातरया जुहाव पुत्रेति तन्मे तया तर्वोभिनेदु तं सर्वभूतहृदयं मुनिनां। तवैवास्मि तवैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे तन्मे मां चरणं।
Of Rishi Namisharani. They asked a question to Srila Sukha Goswami that Sukhadeva Goswami was renounced, had not attached to anyone, even like mad. In Krishna prem, he never stayed to any door, any grihastha, to anywhere more than 2 minutes. Never. He was not attached to any worldly things. He had no attachment, wanting nothing in this world. How he met Parikshit Maharaj and he told Srimad Bhagavatam to him, then he is doing that. After Krishna, he disappeared with his all associates of Vrindavan, Mathura and Dwarka. Then Kali wanted to enter in his or this world. Once he was after Krishna, Parikshit was made the king of Indraprastha, and the Vajrana He was brought by Parikshit Maharaj. He was brought up. And he, Parikshit Maharaj, gave the kingdom of Mathura, Susen Rajya, to Vajrana. He discovered the pastime places of Krishna, which had been become like dense forest. No one knowing where is Radhakund, Shyamkund, Vrindavan, Kamyavan or all ones, and where, what he had done. He discovered all this with the Sandilya Muni and other rishis. And then he has gone to hunter. Okay?
Hunting.
Never killing. Only for show he is doing, because he was Kshatriya. So he became so thirsty. And he was so much tired. And he went to a rishi, Angiras, who was in very deep trance of Bhagavan Krishna. The king asked some water. Oh, I want to take water. Please give me water. I'm so thirsty. But he was in a so deep trance that he could not drink water. At once he became somewhat angry. Anger takes all the what? Intelligence and everything. That is the root of all evils. So, where is Navadvipa? Always become late. If any place here, near court, you can become late. I will punish one day. Very much. So, what I just don't be angry. That is why Guru tells that keep this finger out of your heart, that bag, and then chant Hare. Don't touch by this finger. It denotes, I will break your legs. I will punish you. You know that who am I? By false egos. So try to take it out of that bag that is your heart. Mahaprabhu has also told, Gita has also told, Krishna told to Arjuna, krodha esha, kama esha, krodha esha, rajogun sumat bhava. And it takes all the intelligence and everything. Though Parikshit Maharaj, out of anger, was pure devotee, but yet he shows, plays a part of, like drama, like by anger he lost his intelligence. So quickly, he told the Lord, I will I will give a very good godly presentation gift. And he took a dead snake and gave three rounds. And quickly he returned, but in the way he was repenting, what mistake I've done? Oh, blunder I've done. And in the meantime, a student of that rishi came at once and told that Maharaj, when you gave dead snake in the neck of that rishi, his son was playing anywhere on the bank of a river with so many boys, age 5 years, naked. And he heard that any king had done this. And at once he became angry and took water from the river and did ashman and told, oh, now we have kept some dogs to look after kitchen. But dogs now, very greedy, entering our
kitchen
and they want to take something. Now these Kshatriyas means this
warrior, administrative class.
They like Kshatriya, those who are like kings, ruler, they are dogs. We Brahman made them like a doorkeeper, watchkeeper. But now they have entered and taking all the things which we had offered to Krishna. Now they have become so desperate. I will teach a lesson to them. Attacking them, saying this, and he took water. And it's so. Though who may be anyone. He has insulted my father, not my father, but Brahmanist Rishi. So this water will go to that person. And a snake, very poisonous snake, will bite him on the end of 6-7 days. And anyone cannot say, he must die. And telling this, he began to weep. And he came to his father and saw that, oh, dead snake is really there. He took off it and began to cry, weep so much, loudly. After some time, his trance was gone. And, oh my boy, why you are weeping so loudly? Father, see, anyone has given this dead snake and he has offended you. So I have given some Brahmashrap. What Brahmashrap? Then after 7 days, this snake will go and bite the king and he will die. Oh, at once, he told, oh boy, you are not running. How will you do it? I am seeing that it has been done by Parikshit Maharaj. He is so pious. Good king, very religious, devotee, and you have given cause to him. It seems that you are not Brahmin. You have no qualities of Brahmin. Brahmin should tolerate everything. A devotee also should tolerate everything. Don't be upset if anyone offends you or this. Keep quiet. Like Prahlad Maharaj, Haridas Thakur. Otherwise, Krishna Prem is not so easy that in a minute you will take. You will have to talk. Trinanda Vishnu is that is so. So he rebuked his son. And after that, at once he sent that person, his one student, that go at once and tell Parikshit Maharaj, he should do whatever he wants to do. 7th day, death is sure. Parikshit Maharaj heard this and became so happy. So happy. Why happy? He told that, oh, it is not Brahmashrap, but himself Krishna has come mercifully. It is the mercy of Krishna himself. I wanted to give up this world, kingdom, wife and sons and everything. Because I have played in the lap of Krishna. He has saved me, not for all these things. So, now I am thinking that Krishna has come in the shape of this cause. So, I must at once give up all these things. He took his crown, royal dresses, his bow and arrows and everything, and quickly went on the bank of Ganges. And he began to prayopavation, means not taking anything, water even, water or anything. And he was praying to Krishna, what should I do now? And knowing this thing, from all parts of our world, Vasishtha, Gautam, Vishwamitra, Hari, Deval, Asit, and all Parashar, Narad, also Narad, Vyas, and Parshuram, all prominent. Kashyap Rishi went from Caspian Sea, from Mangal Rishi, came from Mongolia. So many rishis from all over the world. Some came from Partha. Partha, you know?
Australia.
Partha, Australia. Yeah. So from all other parts. All. Some came from Ramanakdeep. Ramanakdeep?
Vidhi.
So, all the rishis. In a moment, at that time was no discovery of wireless or
computer, internet,
nothing. But how they knew? And at once they quickly came, no aeroplane, nothing like this. And more than 1 lakh, so many grihastha, so many karmi also, all assembled there. At that time there were a culture of Shabda Brahma. Shabda Brahma means world Brahma. And by this all knew at once. It is more important than today's
modern science
is lame and quite blind. They cannot make a leg of an ant. Never they can. If the leg of ant is broken, they cannot make an ant. They cannot know what is soul here existing, but they will try to go to moon and sun and Brihaspati. So, at that time, science was so of high class, all assembled. A boy also came. His name was Sukadeva Goswami. Quite naked, like mad. Woman seeing that boy, taking some
dust
and throwing. And boy some, having some, and they were telling, throwing to Sukadeva Goswami. But he has nothing to see. Again, and at once Narad, Das and all rishis, Vasishtha also of Satyayuga, all stood up and they welcomed. And then Parikshit Maharaj fell flat on the lotus feet of Sukadeva Goswami. And then he took him to the Das Ashram. And then he prayed himself. What is a duty of person who is just now dying? Just ready, in a moment he will die. And also second question, that those who are not dying just now, but day or tomorrow, day after tomorrow, after 10 years, 20 years, 100 years, 100 years, 1000 years, they must die. So what they should do? And then Parikshit Maharaj and Sukadeva Goswami then began to address all rishis and Parikshit Maharaj and telling Srimad Bhagavatam. So you should hear all these things from this Sanghita, Brahmi Sanghita, which Vyasa had taken, seen in his trunks. One thing I forgot. One day Parikshit Maharaj, before this, he was touring in his kingdom and he saw a cow and a bullock. Bull. And cow was so lean and thin. And that bull, he has only one leg and broken. His three legs were broken. Partly one leg was there. And black person, like Kali, very mota taja, fatty, very bhayanak, ferocious. And he was beating with mota danda. Sometimes to cow and sometimes to that bull. And they were weeping. They were so weak that they cannot run. And he was weeping. Parikshit Maharaj at once saw and became so merciful. And he took his bow and arrow. At once I will shoot him. Then that person began to do like this. Oh, said me, who are you? Why you are doing? And he told that, who are you? Cow? I sense that you are not cow or not bull. Who are you? Then cow told that I am Prithvi. Prithvi means Bharat. And this bull is Dharma. Now he is without legs. Only three legs have been gone and one is, and that is also broken. Dharma. Shaucha, Daya, Dan, and Dharma. What is Shauch? Like Putana. All what? Unworthy things, impure things, is the Shiva, the embodiment of that. So all are engaged in this. There is no pavitrata, pureness. If they can take what three times shower, but yet their heart is so bad. No dan. Dan meant donations to us. At first, up to Dwapar Yuga, all is used to give some bhik to others. No one wants to do like this. But when Kali Yuga came, all began to do like this. Even king. I know that from India so many kings and so many presidents and so many ministers, prime ministers from all over the world, they come to America and England, France, Germany, Japan to beg something. All beggars. It has gone. And Satya. Short meaning? Not duplicate. In inner heart something and outer something. Where you are going? He will tell. If he is going to west, he will tell. Oh, I am going to south, east. Where you are going? If he is going to north, he will tell south. He will not be true. So, everything now, jhutha lena, jhutha chabena in India. Jhutha lena, jhutha dena, jhutha chabena, jhutha everything. Everything is now
false.
False. Not something. Cheating also, your atma also, our atma. Always cheating. We can earn money by cheating others. Very expert in cheating. All is cheating another. All thinks that I am very intelligent, I am cheating him, and he thinks that I am cheating others. So all cheating others. The Satya, Daya, no mercy. How mercy? We are so merciful like this. Any person, especially one Muslim, he was so kind. He has kept a murgi, murgi you know, hen. And one like bakari.
Goat.
She goat. And he used to love so much to that hen and the goat. After 1 year they became so fat. Now Bakrid was coming. Bakrid, you know?
Festival.
A festival of Muslims. And then festival, they will cut that hen and goat. And now they have become so much fat. So he is so much kind to them and supporting and giving always and curashing. And they don't know all these things. And when they cut, or we are so much kind like a person that any thief came in his house and he was caught handed, red handed caught. The master of the house told, oh, don't beat him. Maramat, don't beat him. Be kind to him. Take him and you should fall in a very deep well. He will automatically die. So we are so much kind like this. So everything is gone. Dharma is telling Bull that all the saints nowadays reading Bhagavatam and taking so much donation for this and maintaining their
families
and testing all these things. So the essence of Srimad Bhagavatam has gone away. So many renowned persons have so much luxurious his house, that is, palatial buildings, that even Grihastha king has not sought such. Or everything golden, his court, his bedding, his everything, his almira of gold and jewels. So what was the need of getting renowned? And Grihastha dying, starving, not anything. Oh, ladies also like that. All their beauty by decorating their hairs and
lipstick.
Not by brahmacharya. Oh, automatically beautiful by brahmacharya. Which will pick from inside. Only decorating. Only this, nothing. And the persons, males, always cheating others, chatting others. So we are very, very for this. Then Parikshit Maharaj at once became so, oh, this is Kali, and due to this it has going on. So he took his bow and arrow. Oh, I will at once kill him. So then he began to pray, why Prabhu you are doing so? We are four brothers. Satya, Satyu, and Treta, Dwapar and Kali. We are four brothers. Our father had divided our kingdom four times according to time. My three brothers, elder brothers, had tested. But now this is my period. So why you are killing me? Be kind to me. Give some places there where I can be there. Then he became happy. So don't go here and there. Only you should situate in these four things I am giving. Dyutam, Panam, Istriyam, Suna, Jatra, Adharmasya Chaturvidha. Where there is a dharma, that is in four things. Dutam, gambling. Panam. Panam means all kinds of intoxications. Wine, cigarette, churut, ganja, bhang, afini, even joy, coffee, all these things. Cigarette, beer, or anything like that. Any kinds of dhumrapan, smoking, or taking, all these things. And third, istriyam. They think, those who think that all the males have been created only for our taste. They are not thinking anyone that she is my mother, she is my sister, she is my daughter. There you can be. And where always inside is going on.
Violence
is going on. By tan, man, bachan, by
body,
mind, and never we should try to give pain to others. I see that so many persons in very morning going to sea or anywhere, keeping some fishing there and killing so many fishes. I think that if anyone very stout person will go and he will tell that, oh, give me your bansi, I also want to fish. And he will give that thing like ace, hook in his mouth. And then he should, how will he will feel? So, you should go to all these places. He told that, oh, these places are very, very small. Please give me that I can somewhat go here and there. Then he told, oh, where there is gold. Gold means money. You should go there. Then all things will come automatically, all kali. Gambling, wine, and drinking all these things, sluttering and everything, and bebichar. All bad things will be there. And then you can be there. And be. Okay. And after that he went to that rishi, and after that he had gosh. So we should try so much to be careful from all five things. Otherwise, you cannot be devotee. I did see that so many devotees now lacking of all these things, association, good association, they become so weak. Those who were bona fide devotees in the time of Swamiji, now becoming so weak, they are taking ganja bhang. Oh, I am so okay. I am chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Of him, and so many things they are taking. They are forgotten to chant. Sometimes they can chant one or not even. So I am requesting all to be very careful for five things and try to become pure devotee. I think that Kali is also one place, very important place. They can be helped, five classes of person. But those who are Mayavadi, they cannot be helped. They are more dangerous, more dangerous. Anyone cannot help them. So try to be careful now. Mayavadi, anyone. If you want to love Krishna and want to be happy forever, then don't go to Mayavadis and listen to them and follow them. Whether his father, mother, guru, even he should be given up. So five and one is six. Then pure devotion may come and help you. Krishna will arrange for good association also. So then he began to tell, then he told something for real bhakti and something to be virakta hone ke liye sansar se. That one is what? Like very suffering food, full of miseries, to realize this. So he began to tell Dhruva Charitra, Ajamil Charitra, Prahlad Charitra, Kapil Devuti Sambhad, Puranjan, and then Chitraketu Maharaj Upakhyan, Ambarish Maharaj, all. Why? That they will hear all these things. Also Ramacharitra, that is Raman and Jai Vijay, like Hiranyakashipu, Hiranyaksha. Also all these things. Only to Virakti Sansasya.
Become detached from materialism.
And he told 10th canto for love and affection to attain. Braj Prem to be. And that was Nigam Kalpato Rupanita. So both should be taken. If you are not qualified so much, then we will have to go first from one canto to ninth. And then you will realize that world is like dream. The relations are dream-like. We cannot attain happiness. And then a detachment will come. But it cannot come automatically. By chanting, remembering, doing some devotional service, then it will come. And it will be forever. Otherwise, by hearing these things, it may be that for temporary vairagya will come, but it will not be durable. So, we should always hear Harikatha, pastimes of Krishna, very strong. That Vyas, in his last days, he received from Nara. And he did Srimad Bhagavatam. So, also in all these pastimes of devotees, like Dhruva, Prahlad, there are some essence to be taken. Somewhat Mishra Bhakti. Some mixed with karma. Something Jnana. Then Jnana Bhakti. Then pure Bhakti. And there, very pure Bhakti up to Vaikuntha. And then Dwarka Bhakti. And then Braj Bhakti. In Braj Bhakti also, Sakya Bhava, friendship, then Vatsalya, and moreover, Gopi Bhava, Gopi serving to Krishna. Among all the Gopis, four, Swapaksha Vipaksha, Tatastha, and among them, Srimati Radhika is more. She is the Parashakti, Antaranga Shakti, Swarup Shakti of Krishna. No, different. So first we will come from Dhruva. Oh, you can tell some Dhruva, Charitra. Can you? Go. Very boldly. Where is speaker?
So, Namo Vishnupadaya Krishna Pustakul Kanshanate Govardhana Sama. Namo Vishnupadaya Radhikaya Priyamanesha Shimad Bhaktivaya Nandarantilaya. Namo Vishnupadaya Krishna Pustakul Kanshanate Bhaktivaya Nandarantilaya. Govardhana Charyam Nishesha Sundari Pasakata.
Oh, I have done pranam for all. So quickly you should go on. यहाँ पर स्वर्ण सा जगह छोड़ो जैसे कि ये आएगा कि यहाँ से भाग ना भी बैठो कल से आशा
सो ध्रुव महाराज
गौन गौन गौन
ध्रुव महाराज at a very young age he wanted to sit on the lap of his father. His father's name was Dhutanapad. And his stepmother, whose name was Suruchi. Suruchi, she said to Dhruva that actually you're not qualified to sit on the lap of the king, Dhutanapad. That for you to be qualified, that you have to be born from my womb, and then you'll be able to sit on the lap. So then Dhruva, he was a Kshatriya, he was very, very hurt by this. He took it as a great insult. So he went to his mother, whose name was Suniti, and he asked his mother, how is it that I can get a kingdom which is greater than than my father's kingdom. So then Suniti, she told him that, I've heard that if you go and you worship Lord Vishnu, then he can fulfill your desire. So he asked, where can I find Lord Vishnu? And she told him that if you go to the forest, I've heard that you can find him in the forest. So these two ladies, Ruchi and Suniti, their names have significance. Suruchi means that one who has great taste, but her taste is for material sense enjoyment. And Suniti means one who is taken to the path of regulated spiritual life. So she gave Dhruva Maharaj this advice that you should go to the forest and perform austerities. So Dhruva Maharaj, he went to the forest and he was very determined to perform his austerities. And going there, then Narada Muni, he appeared on the scene. And Narada Muni, he tested Dhruva Maharaj. Because Dhruva, he was very determined that he must get this kingdom. And Narada Muni came and he asked, oh, but you're such a young boy, you're only 5 years old, and you're the son of a king, you're a very tender young boy, why are you going through all these, why do you want to have such a kingdom? Why do you want to undergo such austerity? And Dhruva Maharaj, he was very determined, and he just told Narada Muni that, if you can help me, then please, you can give me instruction. Also, he told him that, I know that your instructions to me to not to take this to heart, what my father's told me, I know that this is true. But because I'm a Kshatriya, I'm a son of a king, then it's very difficult for me to follow such instructions. So if you can help me and give me such instructions, how I can get such a kingdom, which is greater than my father's, then please help me. So then Narada Muni, he saw that this boy is very determined. Only 5 years old, he's left home, he's gone in the middle of the forest, where so many animals, lions, tigers, snakes, etc. But he's completely undaunted, he's just fixed on his goal. So Dhruva Maharaj is teaching here that one who takes the spiritual path, then one has to be very determined. Ekeha. In Bhagavad Gita that is there, Ekeha Kuru Nandana. That one who's Bahushaka Hiranteshcha, one who's many branch, going for different material desires, then one cannot take to a spiritual path. So even though Dhruva Maharaj, his motivation was materially tinged, but he had this qualification of determination and also honesty. He was honest with Narada Muni. So Narada Muni, seeing this qualification in Dhruva Maharaj, then he gave him mantra. By which he could attain his goal. So then Dhruva Maharaj, he started to chant the mantra which was given by Narada Muni. And it's explained that the details I am forgetting.
Go on.
So he explained that, it's explained in Srimad Bhagavatam that first he was only taken
some dry fruits and
leaves. Some fruits or leaves?
Fruits or leaves.
He was only taking fruits or leaves
in
for a period
of 4 or 5 days.
For a period of 4 or 5 days. And then after that, then he stopped. He stopped taking the leaves and then he just started to take water for a period of
7 days after he used to take.
Every 7 days, then he would take some water. Then after that, he stopped taking water, and then he just started to live on the air. And he would breathe every
15 days.
Every 15 days. So,
and then he came in trance. Totally then, stopping air. What are all things? And then Brahma was disturbed. All demigods were disturbed. And then Narayan himself came in the fourth horn, Sankh Chakra Gada Padma all taken. After a moment, he came out from his heart and he became so
restless.
And he opened his eyes and he saw that, he's there. And Krishna, that is Narayan, gave him guiding direction that for 36,000 of years, you will be the king monarch of a whole world. And telling at once quickly disappeared. What wonder of that. There was Chintamani. Chinta means?
Such
a storm. And I missed it. And I collected only some broken pieces of glass. And then began to weep. But Narayan has disappeared, nothing to do. At once his father came, mother came, and all came and took them to kingdom and they gave. And he was the ruler for 36,000 years. What is the purpose in this? He has so many beautiful wives, sons and grandsons, very beautiful and strong. He has full of his khajana.
Treasure
was full of gold and everything. Everything in life he has attained, but he was not. Without bhakti, he cannot be happy. He left at once. And at the same time, death came and he kept his fate on the head of that death and quickly went to Haridham, that is Dhruva Loka. If anyone is not following the rules and regulations and teachings of Srimad Bhagavatam, Gita, Bhava and Ved Upanishad, and want to taste all these things, worldly desires, then they are like donkey, no intelligence. So Sukadeva Goswami told this to Parikshit Maharaj. Don't be like this. You are so lucky that you have left all these things. So we should take lesson from Dhruva. In 33,000 years she was monarch, having everything that we want, more than Indra, he has everything. But he was not pleased by this. So you should know that anyone by money, by beautiful sons and daughters and wives, anyone can be happy. Anyone we can be happy only by chanting, remembering the name of Krishna. Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu, Shravanam. He did also like that. That is why he went to that dham. I missed to say one thing today I wanted. I told about Guru yesterday, that a guru like Narada and disciple like Vyas. A guru like Vyas and disciple like Sukadeva Goswami. Not like a guru like Baladeva Prabhu, it is all right. But not disciple like Lomaharshana Sutta. Then a bona fide guru can be served. I've told you any time that there was also a very strong devotee. His name was
Hare Arjun Kerifai.
मारा गया कृष्ण चक्र से एकलव. So many, I have seen that so many devotees in the line of Swamiji, they gave name to their disciples Ekalabhya. Ekalabhya Maharaj. Oh, friendful name. I want to tell you that if you have some intelligence, we should try to think whether Ekalabhya was bona fide disciple or not. He must be, because his guru told that at once you should give me your right thumb. And he at once gave. So why not very qualified devotee? He must be. But we should see, we should judge deep. First he went to Dronacharya. Oh Gurudev, I am accepting you, my Gurudev. Why you are accepting me? I want to learn archery. Why you want? Why? Because I want to defeat Krishna and Arjuna. Why? Why you want to defeat? Because Krishna and Arjuna are not good persons. They cheat others. Always, he is not equal to all. Sometimes he takes pride of devotees. Not good. Why he does? So I want to defeat Krishna and also Arjuna. I want to kill Arjuna. He told that, I cannot go. You can go to another group. Those who have a mood like this, envy, I cannot. You are not qualified to be admitted in my school. Then he went and he began to learn all these things, keeping a statue of Dronacharya. And he became in some days very expert. One day, Dronacharya, with all Kauravas and Pandavas, all disciples, Arjuna, Bhima, Nakul, Sahadeva, Duryodhana, they were going in a forest. Dronacharya wanted to taste all. In the meantime, a dog was pursuing him, and he began to bark at once. At once they saw that he was barking, but now he has stopped, he is not barking. Why not? They saw that some arrows have filled his mouth and he cannot speak. He cannot bark. No injury, nothing anywhere, but he cannot shout, he cannot bark. Oh, who had done this miracle? Any expert archer. So, from what side it arrows coming and they followed and they saw a very black, young person. Who are you? Oh, he did pranam to Dronacharya. And Dronacharya asked, who are you? I am Ekalabhya, your disciple. Oh, you are my disciple. How you become so expert? I refuse you to take as a disciple. He told that, I made your statue. And here thinking that you are my guru, I am practicing. Oh. Have you paid me Dakshina, Guru Dakshina? No, I have not. But I want to pay. Now you are expert, you should pay Guru Dakshina. Oh, what you like? Oh, I like your this thumb, right thumb. Why? He did not told anything, that five. But he at once took his sword and at once cut and gave Dakshina. Blood was coming. After that, Dronacharya returned. But why he cut? Because he knows his heart. He became friend, he was friend of Duryodhan, Karna, Shakuni. Shakuni, you know, Kali himself, Shakuni. Giving bad advices and helping them. So once it became that he wanted to kill Arjun and also fighting with Krishna, then Krishna took his chakra and at once dangerous. So you should know he was not good. If we should try to follow what our Gurudev wants, then disciple. But Gurudev is telling another thing, one thing, and he is doing another thing, not obeying, disobeying always, not knowing what is the heart of my Gurudev, then actually he is not disciple. Never. So I see in this Kali Yuga there are so many lakhs and lakhs disciples, but very rare disciple qualified. There was a disciple who that world has recognized. Sri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupah Kada Mahiyam Dadati. He has fulfilled all the desires of his Gurudev. He knew the heart of his Gurudev. Who was Gurudev? Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself. He had come to propagate Radhanga Bhakti and to relish pure prema of Srimati Radhika. So he knew the heart of his Gurudev and he expressed in Ujjwal Nirmani Bhakti Rishamesh Guru and so many books. So we should try to be like that. To know what is what my Gurudev wants, what is the desires of my Gurudev. Can you say that what is the desire of any bona fide Guru? He has no any desire. Oh, bring so much gold to me. Money, I have so many projects. I have a project for 10 crores of dollars or 1,000.
Millions
of dollars, I have project. So you should, what you can give. Don't try to give any farthing, pence or farthing to your wives, children and nothing. Give all them to me. I will fulfill my project. It is not good. And those who are not in thinking all these things, and they are following their that unqualified Guru, both Andhai Jathandai Upaniyamana, they will go to hell. Guru will fall first and then his sis also. Both will fall. So we should try to be careful. Also, you know, Karna, brother of Pandavas, elder, he went to Parshuram. He first went to Dronacharya, but Dronacharya refused. Then he went to Parshuram, incarnation of Krishna, God. And he went there. And he became a Brahmin boy. He told that I am Brahmin. I have come to know all the Brahma Vidya with archery and all Vidya. Did not told that I have come only to
only to learn archery.
Brahma Vidya also, archery also, all kinds of Vidya. Parshuram saw that, he is very in certain mood. And from that day, he took
secret sets
he was taking and certain his mood. Very strongly he was. One day, and he began to teach him archery, Brahma Vidya, or everything. One day, Parshuram was sleeping, keeping his head on the lap of Karna. And an insect, very powerful, Vajrakeet. Very powerful, any insect. That is called Vajrakeet.
Very not skulking.
And he came at once and he began to cut. He made a hole in the Jankha.
High
of cut. And he was so patient that, oh, my Gurudev may wake up. So he was. Oh, very patiently he was dealing all these things. Blood so much came that his face was touched by that and oh, from where it is coming? What is this? And then blood and blood. Oh, who are you? I know that now I have known that you are not Brahmin anymore. Who are you? You must be Kshatriya. What is your name? Then he told him, absolutely. He became so fearful. I will at once cause tell what is the truth. Then he told that I have come to you. I am Karna, Aradheya, son of any
Adhira.
And I have come to you to learn Varsity. Why? Oh, to defeat my rival. Then he told, yes, you have served me so much. I have given you all Brahma Vidya and Brahmastra and all kinds of archery and Brahma Vidya also. But when a time will come, neat time, you will fall it. Now, you should remember all these things, all these, it is all right. But when you will need it, you will fall it. When he was Karna returned, and in Mahabharata they were fighting with Arjuna and Karna, and at the very time when both were fighting, at once he forgot all these things. His chariots went on earth and he could not do, and then Arjuna quickly. So don't be a disciple like Karna. Be what you are inner, outer you should be seen. Not polishing, duplicacy with Gurudev. Not don't look towards the pocket of your Gurudev. Gurudev have really Gurudev qualified, they have no any pocket. If they are pockets 3, 4, 5, 6, then he is not actually. But if any Gurudev has pocket to keep very smooth and sweet hearts in their pocket, but not worldly things. If he is so attached, then he is not really Gurudev. Swamiji came to this world who are hippie, who are not so much, they were all like ignorant. He came. And he took all these herbs, whether they are bad or, and he made them smoke very sweet and keep in his pocket. So Vaishnava are like that. Try to be very obedient, honoring all devotees, not quarreling, and so much strong in Krishna faith. Guru then you are hearing Srimad Bhagavatam, otherwise taking by this and giving by it. Go, Premanand. For that he cannot make good cause. He punished him.
Why did they not give so readily?
Giving is not that thing. He gave. But he could not follow his Gurudev. He told that give me that anger and lust and all other things. He wanted. In Vinyasa you should give up envy and all. He could not give. Only he used to give some worldly things. Those who are giving worldly things, donations and all these things, they are really noble. But one who gives his heart fully and know the wishes of Gurudev and following, they are disciples. So he cut the finger, only that he could not fight with her.
Everybody can please move over to this side of the temple room. We're going to have
one
and move this way and face this direction. Thank you.
The disciple returned to his home after the departure of his Gurudev. And he follows instructions very seriously, always chanting and hearing Bhagavad Gita. And he became so qualified that he began to give discourses as well. But one day, a little mouse entered into his life and began a series of events which changed his life.
I just can't think around the cat. And let me ask you one question. What are you feeding the cat?
I don't have time to feed myself.
I'm
coming to you because I have a problem.
This is the problem. You need to feed the cat.
Oh. Doesn't it feed outside birds and insects?
Well, cows, cats, they like to drink milk. So you need to get milk for the cat.
No. Well, how am I going to get milk? There's no dairy for miles. The town's like 5 miles away. You know, my nearest neighbor.
Do not worry. Just so happens, my brother-in-law has one extra cow. He's coming from India raising cows, and too many cows are coming. So I will ask him to try and give you one cow.
You'll give me a cow.
No problem. Then you
but I have no
giving the milk to the cat, your problem.
But I have no money.
No necessity to take money. He will give as a gift to you, just because extra cow. You wait, I will bring to you, your problem will be there.
So this solves the feeling of the cat, the Gurudas' problems have just begun.
Somewhere
in Bhagavad Gita.
So things really change now in the Guru Dharma. At first, Shakti Lord Joy is running into his life, milking the cow, cleaning, cooking for the deity. And again, Guru Dasa would study his Gita. But in time, there was a child on the way. Now let's see what's happening to our Guru Dasa.
His mind constantly engaged in remembering, undeviated from the path, he, O Bhagavan, the shared religion, the powers of Lord.
Just about that time, the Guru Maharaj appeared on the scene.
How has all this come about?
Hey Dave, when I left you, you told told me to study Bhagavad Gita. So I studied it day in, day out. And I learned so many things. And so many people were coming and learning. And they also felt very happy by hearing these teachings of Sri Krishna to Arjuna. But look around, my children, my home. This is my Gita Samsara. This is...
No! This is not the result. Tell the truth. How has this come about?
I was having problems. I was missing the middle chapters of the Bhagavad Gita, the most important chapters actually, chapters 7 through 12. You always told me that those were the most important chapters, Gurudev. And my students were starting to lack something in their teaching, so I had this, it was a mouse that was actually getting my Gita. So I had to buy a cat, you know, to kill the mouse. The cat got hungry, so then I went to Mr. Patel. He's an incredible businessman. He knows all about the stock
market. This is the result of taking shelter of worldly-minded people. You should have come to your Gurudev. Perhaps you would not have become so entangled. There is a story about the great Acharya, Śrīla Śrīvāsana. It was time for him to go to the jungle, but there was some hesitation there. He was thinking, how shall I become king? Who will protect me? That time, an egg fell from a nest in a tree and broke. And from that egg emerged a premature, just eyes half closed, struggling, his beak trying to find something to eat. And an insect came, got caught in the sticky part of the egg, and somehow caught the insect. You got something to eat. If you had actually studied Bhagavad Gita, you would have understood. You can only be the instrument. Krishna is providing for all. Krishna is taking care of everyone. You are not the poor. You are just the instrument. You did not fix your mind. You did not depend upon Krishna. Speculate. Now, if you were to leave, they would all be taken care of. But we have some obligation. Come, fall, not the tea, fat tea, mouth tea, repeat that. Hare Krishna, Kirtan Hare, Hare Krishna.
and materials, or set of, yeah, materials to fetch you for. Where should we go? That's where you're from the city.
Are you guys
like literally? Let's see, LA tried to invade us a couple months back.
Don't they? Bro, yeah, right, you guys thought.
Oh,
then